Blackstone Publishing presents The 30-Year Genocide, Turkey's Destruction of Its Christian Minorities, 1894 to 1924, by Benny Morris and Dror Ze’evi. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. For my grandchildren, Aliyah and Stavi, Ayala, Zohar, and Matan, Haleli, Eden, Nuri, and Kedem. Benny. And for mine, Itamar and Roy. Dror. Introduction. We embarked on this project in quest of the truth about what happened to the Ottoman Armenians during World War I. Most Western scholarship on the subject has concluded that the Ottoman Empire, exploiting the fog and exigencies of war, carried out a genocidal campaign that resulted in 1 million or so Armenian dead. Turkish and pro-Turkish scholars have argued that Turkey, embattled by the British and Russian empires, was assailed from within by treacherous Armenians and simply defended itself. On this view, thousands of Armenians died amid deportation from troublesome combat zones, while the Turks suffered significant casualties at Armenian hands. Turning to the available contemporary documentation, we set out to discover for ourselves what had actually happened and why. We found the proofs of Turkey's 1915 to 1916 anti-Armenian genocide to be incontrovertible. The reports by Leslie Davis, the U.S. wartime consul in Harput in central Turkey, offer a good illustration. Davis was no Armenian lover. In December 1915, he questioned Armenians' moral fiber, writing, "Mothers have given their daughters to the lowest and vilest Turks to save their own lives. Lying and trickery and an inordinate love of money are besetting sins of almost all. Absolute truthfulness is almost unknown among the members of this race. From every point of view, the race is one that cannot be admired." But he did not let his prejudices cloud his eyesight. During the deportations, Davis sent home dozens of reports describing the Turkish atrocities, which he summarized in a conclusive memorandum in early 1918. In these reports, he recalled observations such as that of September 24, 1915, when he toured the area southeast of Harput around Lake Gochuk, Hazar Gou, accompanied by the American missionary Dr. Henry Atkinson. "We saw dead bodies all along the road. They had been partially eaten by dogs. There were several hundred bodies scattered over the plain, mostly of women and children. Some of the bodies had been burned by Kurds in order to find any gold which the people may have swallowed. In most of the lakeside valleys there were dead bodies. In one valley there were more than 1,500. The stench was great. I explored this valley more carefully a month later. An old Kurd told us that the gendarmes had brought a party of about 2,000 Armenians and had made the Kurds from the neighboring villages come and kill them. He acted very indignant, as he said the smell of their dead bodies was very disagreeable." The old man also described a system whereby Armenians were massacred. They were, he said, allowed to camp for a day or two in the valleys. The gendarmes summoned the local Kurds and ordered them to kill the Armenians. An agreement was then made by which the Kurds were to pay the gendarmes a certain fixed sum, a few hundred pounds or more, depending on circumstances, and were to have for themselves whatever they found on the bodies, in excess of that sum. Davis learned that the people were forced to take off their clothes before they were killed, as the Mohammedans considered the clothes taken from a dead body to be defiled. Most of the dead had bayonet wounds. Few had been shot, as bullets were too precious. Nearly all of the women lay flat on their backs and showed signs of barbarous mutilation. One of these lakeside massacres was witnessed by three Europeans on September 17th, a week before Davis's first trek. They saw Kurds on the hills above the lake shoot up a large Armenian convoy, and then, bearing axes, attack the defenseless flock like ferocious animals. Kurdish women ran down the hillside to strip the bodies. What happened at Lake Gochuk in August to September 1915 was emblematic of the Armenian genocide. But we discovered that the Armenian genocide of 1915 to 1916 was only part of the story, a story that began decades before and extended for years afterward. The story is both deeper and wider than the Armenian genocide. It is deeper in the sense that the events of 1915 to 1916 were part of a protracted history of violence. One has to look at Turkish behavior before and after.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.